Believe it or not, New Zealand has around 36 species of native fish. And no, I'm not talking about trout or salmon. The problem with our fish is they tend to be small, sneaky, and hard to find. So DOC uses a pretty ingenious way of finding them: electric fishing. And it works a treat. Baby, I've been watching you. Baby, I've been watching you. Watching everything you do. Just can't help but feeling someone else is stealing you away from me. I see it written. Martin, what is electric fishing?
Electric fishing is a technique used for research that basically puts electricity into the water to stun the fish. It's done using this backpack electric fishing machine, and basically the current goes down into the water and any fish in that field will get stunned.
What about you guys?
We've got rubber gum boots, rubber gloves, and also we have to be trained to make sure that we know the safety rules and abide by them.
Okay, well, shall we get down the
yeah,
bank
sure.
And go and get stuck in?
Go and have a look.
Why are we interested in what's in the water?
Well, because part of our job is to look after freshwater fish.
And
to find out what's in the water, we need to do that somehow, and electric fishing is actually a really effective technique to do that. Oh, you're slipping away from me. Oh, you're slipping away from me. We've got a long finned eel. That's this fish here.
Long finned eels are New Zealand's only native species of eel, in that they are only found in New Zealand. They're really ancient species of eel. There's a short finned eel.
And we've also got in this tray here, this is a torrent fish.
If you're a fish nerd, this is exciting stuff.
It's actually related to the blue cod, believe it or not. It's really adapted to living in fast water. Look at those big front fins, really help it kind of hold itself on the bottom in fast water. And like a lot of the native freshwater fish, they spawn in fresh water. The little larvae hatch out and drift out to sea, then come back in the springtime, and then, you know, rear in fresh water and grow up into the adult fish. We've got some enanga.
Yep.
If you're eating a whitebait patty, the young of this fish would make up most of that patty, if you like. It's the most common of the whitebait species.
And is he full size?
That's pretty much full size. They do get bigger than that, but it's good to see so many fish in a stream in an urban setting.
The amazing thing about what we found here today is that we are smack bang in the middle of central Nelson. We're surrounded by houses, and yet we got a huge variety of water wildlife here. So that's a good sign for the health of the river. We'll put them back and let them go about their business and live to fight another day. Breaking me in two, watching you slipping away. And it's breaking me in two, watching you slipping away.